radio DJ. And I'll tell you what, let me go ahead and turn on some of the music. And I think I have that on here.
Who's Neil Bohr?
I'll turn a little bit of, kind of, it's not exactly Christmas music, but kind of, I got it on Jazz Fusion right now, so, Neil, what's a Neil Bohr? Neil Bohr, I guess he's one of the, now, I'll tell you what, now, right before I got in the military, I had actually hair longer than Howard Stern, so, yeah. And, see, the, even the kids don't know this. Shh, don't.
Long hair?
Oh, yeah, actually, I had it down the middle of my back, believe it or not. Unfortunately,
so
I don't
Jamie.
Think I have any... Oh, did he? Oh, my gosh, we're hearing some rumors that are getting good now. Yeah, do you have pictures of it?
He does, yeah.
Dang, we need to see those pictures online. No, just kidding.
Looks like a girl.
And now, I think, now, Smart Scarecrow, I think he mentioned as well, he had kind of long hair. Now, I did have mine down to the middle of my back, and it sounded really... Well, I had it cool. It looked cool, though. I had it in a semi-perm, believe it or not, in the 80s. This is in the 80s, but, you know, I had it was well-kept. It wasn't dirty or anything like that. It was, the good old 80s. And I tried to grow mine out long after I got out of the Navy, and it didn't work for me. So I tried to grow it out a little long, and I was like, this is not working. I don't know why. Maybe because I'm getting younger. I don't know. Yeah. Well, you know, what's the longest hair you ever had here, Jenny?
Probably now.
Really?
A little bit longer than this. Yeah. I've been trying to grow my hair out for like a year.
Now, I think you had it like, I don't know how long ago, you chopped, like one year you came back and you had it chopped off all.
But, got tired of it.
Well, I guess, I think in the military, because... It's kind of hard each day. You gotta like put it up.
Put it in a bun. It's a pain in the ass. Oh, can you guys?
Oh, they're gonna ban us. They're gonna ban us off the internet. Oh my gosh. Usually, if you don't, yeah. Usually, this is a family channel. No, that's okay. They're not gonna ban us, I think, for that. I don't know. They should. You know, I think they'll let the guys grow it long too. But you know, I guess it'll never happen. Oh, grow your hair out, pops, just to do it.
Just to do it.
I tried. It just didn't work.
You just cut it.
Yeah, now mine's short. Well, I made a mistake, and she asked me, do you want it where you can spike it up? Or something like that. And I'm like, yeah. And then you know, to spike it up, you have to cut it shorter. And I'm not going to do that again. I think that was too short. That kind of sucked. Because, yeah, you can spike it, but it's kind of too short for me, you know.
Just grow a mohawk.
A mohawk, oh my gosh. I don't know.
What do they call it, a faux hawk? I think that's what they call it.
Well, that's different because you, it's just the center strip is longer than the size, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wait a minute. Mitch, you're in the disco era. Oh, yeah, that's right. Is that the year you were born, 1955? There, Mitch. Disco. Do you know disco, Jenny?
I wasn't even born.
Yeah, but they play disco music, you know, every once in a while. Like overseas? Yeah, it's... I think there's a few clubs that play, like, disco music, I guess.
Nope.
You'd be surprised, like the you know, Japanese, they go wild over the American music and everything else. So you actually had platform shoes. How high were those things?
They got all kinds of Japanese people in Hawaii.
Oh, yeah, that's right, yeah. I mean, yeah, they have the native Hawaiians, but you have a lot of Japanese. I think because it's pretty close to Hawaii, right?
Yep. They got Hawaiians, Japanese, Koreans, all kinds.
And,
They look at me and I'm like I'm a local.
You know, I heard this before that, you know, let's say you get all kind of different Asians get together and sometimes they can't really tell what nationality they are. They think, you know, even they can't tell sometimes. Like, they think one is... Korean when she they're actually Japanese and vice versa.
Yeah. It's sometimes harder to tell them apart.
I don't know. I'm usually pretty good. I'd say maybe 60-70% of the time, maybe.
What?
On guessing if one's Asian or not. You know, what part Asian.
Yeah. I like doing that.
I don't know, you gotta be careful. You gotta be careful because some are very touchy, you know, if you call them a certain,
you
know.
Oh, yeah, well, you don't do it to their face.
No, you're like, you know, if you know them a while, then you're like,
It's like Black Friday, 24/7 here.
Oops, our radio just went out on us. But yeah, you gotta be very careful because, you know, you go, you know, you gotta kind of like, you know, kind of see how they respond and I'm just saying, you know, I think you look Korean or whatever. And people are curious, I guess. Oh, wait a minute. Koreans and Japanese do not get along. Do they? They don't? Okay, I didn't know that. And now I heard this. I don't know if it's a rumor or not. Like, certain Japanese don't like Filipinos. I'm not trying to make Asian wars or anything, just you know, this is one of the things I've heard. I don't know if it's, you know, I don't know, I think it's just you know, I'm not saying it's a general. That could be it. Yeah, you're right, they're smart scarecrow. Yeah, well, just like some Japanese, they don't like some of the, I'm talking about the old ones that are been around since World War II. They don't particularly like, you know, Americans because of the you know, the atomic bomb and things like that. So, you know, I could see me be like that. I'll be like, when I get old, I'll be the cranky old guy, you know, leave me alone.
Oh, when we went to Okinawa, they were pretty nice. All the Japanese.
Okinawans? Okay.
Yeah.
Now, I did live in Japan for a while, Yokosuka, for about 2 years. Japanese people are actually very friendly, probably one of the friendliest, I have to say. But I know some of the military over there did some kind of bad things to some of the, you know, locals, and you know, so, you know, you know, oh, I hate to say it online during the show, but then I think, you know, after a while, a lot of the Japanese started getting, you know, a pet peeve against the, you know, I think it was just the military, American military, I guess. But so, you know, nowadays you got to be careful, I guess. Now the, I'm trying to think, not fraternization, what do you call it? I know we used to have training every year on it, and what do you call it? Well, you had fraternization, that was one. It was another training we had to get every year, and that was along those lines. And U.S. imposed.
EO, equal opportunity.
Equal, yeah, I think I mentioned that. Equal opportunity was one. Fraternization, yeah, I forgot. It was like a whole thing. It was, and I think they did it over, like, you know, I think some commands did it over a week even. I guess the phone's ringing off the hook now. Usually it doesn't do it when, you know, during the show, but now there was something also, because I know for a while they, women in the military, they weren't allowed to go on combat ships or out to the front and things like that. And haha, I heard Sean. You're psychic. Wow, that's amazing there.
What did he say?
He goes, haha, I heard Sean. Yeah, that's my son answering the phone. It seems to be ringing off the hook right during the show. They recently changed it when I was in. I was on one ship that did allow women, but it was mostly the women officers. It actually had some women in our work center. Yeah, that's right. Now, there was another ship that was only women officers, I think. Not even chief. And
they've already got some women on the submarines now.
Oh yeah, that's right. Officers. That's right. I'm glad you brought that up. Now that surprised me a little bit. And I think there was like the first woman, I think it was an aircraft carrier commander or something like that. And it's been fairly recently as well. I have to say the sub thing surprised me a little bit. You're there, Junior 2684. We're kind of doing open chat right now. I kind of ran out of topics. But surprisingly, we've been having stuff to talk about. I might try to turn on the radio if it didn't go wonky on me.
His headphones hurt. What's been going on with Skype?
I guess that's what Jenny asked. What's going on with Skype? I guess they couldn't log in. I think that's what it was earlier. And of course, I'm a broadcaster, and I have other friends as well that are broadcasters. And Skype's a big thing with us because we often Skype in other people, audio, and sometimes even video, so you can see their video. And luckily today, like I said, you know, you were in the studio, I wasn't Skyping you in, then there would have been a lot of problems. So I think of the children. Wow. Oh, only Chris could think up something like that. That big multimedia tycoon, I guess. Oh, look at what Smart Scarecrow, he put something in there. I do not like the idea of women in the military. Uh-oh. But I am old and remember the day when we went off to war to protect our women, never expecting them to fight next to us. Well, I could see that, you know, because to me it's more of a... To me it's more of a generation gap thing, perhaps, because, you know, when you're a lot older, you're used to the way things when you grew up, so... And I think that's why we didn't really have women in the military, or as far as in combat, because they were afraid that the men would, you know, run in front of the women and they get shot protecting them or something like that.
What?
Yeah, I swear that's what it is. See, I think it's the opposite. I think they would pull the women in front of them before getting hit. No, I'm just saying, you know, I don't think it's really that way, but... sometimes you never know how somebody's going to respond. It could be both.
Aww.
Well, as far as, you know, saving the women or the men, some of the men running away. I tell you what, I've seen something very similar. This was during the first Gulf War. We're actually shooting off, I think cruise missiles. And we're inside the ship and they were firing him off, and there's actually this Filipino guy, and he started getting like really upset, you know, kind of talking crazy, I guess, because we were shooting him off, I guess during wartime or whatever. I think he was the only one, though. He was a little nervous, I could tell. So, see you later there, Mitch. I guess he left. Thanks for coming to the show. That's Mitch, 1955. And we're showing... 8:44 p.m. Central Time. Okay, we're doing open chat right now, and thank everybody in the chat room right now for coming to the Christmas show with our guest as well, which is Beneath Everything. Ronnie Rucker, I missed you coming in. Welcome to the show. Kyler Brown, 174. Chad, 77. RMX, 77. Sergeant, 1980s. Smart Scarecrow. Jay MacDuff is in the house. Oh my gosh, there's two Jay MacDuffs. Who is that other one?
Me.
Oh, okay, that was you. Okay, I forgot. The other MacDuff. Okay, we got K Junior 21, Last Call with Chris, Linux Lifer, oh my gosh. Man Cave Weekly, Tech Trainer, and Tom Rosenberg. And now it says UAL, but he wants to be called by Uncle Al. So usually every time I forget. So it's so hard to run a multi-billion dollar company with no Skype. And let me see how many people in the chat room that are not logged in. Let me see.
Hey, Sean.
About 21. Did Sean log in?
No, Jamie's brother, Sean.
Oh, I didn't know that. So there's two Seans in the
family. He spells his name different.
Oh, yeah, of course, yeah. Yeah, different spelling. Okay. At first, I was like, did he log in? I was like looking in the chat room to see if my son was in there. And I think he did that one time, but he